In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this cool 3D menu with animated icons in Unity. So to start things off, create a UI canvas and then use the screen space camera render mode. So go to right click on the scene, go to UI, then you want to go to canvas. Then you right click the render mode and change this to screen space camera. And then grab your camera in the scene and drag it onto this render camera variable. And then change order and layer to 1 so that it's in front of the objects in your scene. And then to make that 3D menu, rotate, I'm gonna create a panel. So go to UI and then panel. And notice how large it is. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna hold down the Alt key, click this center anchor point. Let's change the width to 300 and let's do 400 on the height. And then we're gonna change the scale to 0.1. And see where the panel is in relation to the to the objects in the scene. Well, I'm gonna grab this panel and I'm gonna move it so that it shows up. And now I can rotate it. So I'm gonna click the right key. E key as a shortcut. And now you can rotate. One second, let me move this a little bit. Now you can rotate the menu. So notice it's in front of this object and it's a little rotatable. If I click Y, I'm gonna change the transform a little bit. That is a little off. Okay, rotate just a little bit more. Let's do it by digits. -10. Okay. I think it's a pretty good, transform position. So once we have it in a place you want to use it, and this panel is able to be rotated, what I want to do is make a button group. And each button, we're going to be able to add an icon to and animate. So in this button group, I'm going to start with an empty UI object. Let's call it button group. And I'm going to use a grid layout so the buttons are all uniform, they're all the same. So if I right-click the grid layout object, go to UI button, if I duplicate these buttons, notice they're all the same. If I change this to say like 50, notice they all change in uniform because it's part of the layout group. So what I could do is modify one button, and once we feel like it looks pretty good, we can just duplicate the button, and so they all look the same, and then we don't have to modify the other ones. So I want to remove these. And since I want this to have an icon with it, I'm going to add an image to it. So right click, image. We're gonna make this like say 25x25. And so you can see it, I'm gonna change it to green. And what's cool is you can swap out this sprite for an icon that you want. The images and the 3D objects that are in the scene right now, I got from the Unity Asset Store. And I'm gonna post links down below in the description of this video. So here's the image. Here's our text. So I'm gonna move this image. If I hold down the Alt key and click one of these anchor presets, I'm gonna click this middle left pivot and it'll bring it over here. And really what I want this image to do is to go from left to right, like as you hover over the button. Say settings. And I'm actually going to make the button a little bit larger so we have more space to work with. And we're going to change the text to be on the left side, a left alignment, and I'm simply gonna move it over. So because this is stretching to the size of the button, I'm gonna give some padding here. So let's do like 50. So you notice that the settings will always start here, and the icon, it'll never be in the way of the icon. And now we can move this over a little bit. Let's say 20. So now if I like duplicate these and change the text, notice it's never in the way of the icon. So what I also want to do is I want the act or the normal state to be invisible. I want this background to be invisible. And when you hover over it, the font changes to black. So right here, if you go to normal color in the button, we're going to change the alpha to 0 so it's invisible. And then we're going to change this to white, or leave it as white. So now when you hit play and hover over the button, notice you don't see anything. And then you hover over and now it's white. So to make it so that the text color changes, we're going to have to do some coding. And that involves using the event handler. And so let's go into the scripts right now and we'll do some cool coding. All right, so when it comes to coding this button, what we want is we want to be able to require a button type, because when you assign this script to a UI component, with this code, it's going to automatically assign a button component if it doesn't exist. Because we want this to be only on a button in our scene. To be able to modify when you hover over the button, so the on pointer enter, and then when you hover off, you're going to use on pointer exit. And you need to use these access these interfaces right here that you want to add to the mono behavior. These are public, so we can assign the text component and image component that we want to use. So what this is saying is, when I hover over the button, we're going to change the text component's color to black, and the image component is going to show up, and you're going to see it. When you hover off the button, the image component goes away, and then the text is now the color of white. So now that the script is done, we're going to go to button, and we're going to go to add component, and look for the menu button script. And then drag on the text component to the text component variable, and then drag on the image component to the image component variable. Okay, so the variables are assigned. Let's play the scene. And then when you hover over, you'll see that the text color will change and the image appears. So now let's look at doing the animation on the icon. We want to animate this icon right here, and we want it to move left to right. So what we're going to do is we're going to add, select the image component, go to add, animation, and then we're going to go to window animation, and we're going to click create animation clip. I call this menu button and save it in an animations folder. And now you'll see this little window right here. We hit the record button, and then I want to move the X value of this. So we're going to start at, let's say 15. I'm going to move it to this 30 frame, keyframe, and then go to 25. And then we're going to move this again to the next 30 keyframes, and then go back to 15. So now when I hit play, it's going to go like this, back and forth. And if you want to make the animation a little slower, you can always extend the keyframes. But for now, we're going to leave it like this. So I want to select this to stop recording, Control S to save the animation. And then I want to drag this animation to the animation clip by default. So now that the animation's working, I want to disable the animation component. Okay, so one thing is I want this to the animation to loop. So click your animation clip and then go to the wrap mode and click loop. And then when you hit play, you'll see the icon animate when I hover over, and then it'll stop when I hover off. And so if you duplicate these, you can see some cool animations going on. And what's cool about this is if I swap, you can easily swap the images. So if I go to the sprite and let me find an icon in my scene, let's do this, delete. I'm gonna change this to an icon, and then I'll change this icon to something, and then when I hover over, now there's an icon that you associated with. So if you know, easy to style. So that's how you create a cool animated 3D menu with Unity, with some animations and icons. And you want to add some kind of a title to your menu. Also, I swapped out the icons for something different. For a title, what you could do is you could right-click the panel here, go to UI, and then Image. We're going to make this, say, 75. And we're going to bring this up a bit. And let's bring it over. And you could add text inside of this and begin center it. And we can, turn off the panel image. And also, one thing to help with visibility is you can add shadows to the text, and things like that. If you're looking for other tutorials, definitely check out the Unity 3D tutorial playlist on my YouTube channel. If you want to follow the development of my indie game, head on over to johnbednes.com and look up The Lost Orcs. I also have two playlists regarding the indie game. One is a gameplay playlist on the YouTube channel, and then another one is the devlog series itself. That's it for this tutorial. If you found this video helpful, put a like on it, please. And if you want more videos like this, definitely let me know. Put it in the comments below if you have any questions too. And thanks again for watching, and have a good one.